Hello friends, now I would like to welcome you for discussion of lecture 3 of unit 5 credit rating. In this lecture series we will discuss credit rating agencies in India and credit rating symbols. In our previous classes we have already seen the various aspects connected with credit rating. What is credit rating? How credit rating is done and what are the various agencies involved in credit rating, the benefits of credit rating to the investors, benefits to the companies which is undergoing a credit rating. And now in this chapter, we will discuss about credit rating agencies in India. We have already seen credit rating in the previous lecture also, what is credit rating. And now we will discuss in detail the various types of credit rating agencies working in our country. And we will also study the credit rating symbols. Now, credit rating agencies in India, there are four credit rating agencies in India which are widely covering the whole rating activities in the country. The basic three are Indian based companies, and the last one is a foreign company merged with Indian company and now operating in India. The first basic three important credit rating agencies which are established by the Indian banks or by the Indian financial forums are CRISIL, Credit Rating Information Services of India Limited. Second one is ICRA, ICRA, Information and Credit Rating Services Limited. And third one is CARE, that is Credit Analysis and Research Limited, CARE. And the last one is Fitch India, Fitch India. Now let us discuss a little bit about each one of these, what they are. CRISIL, for example, the first rating agency, Credit Rating Information Services of India Limited, in India. The country started credit rating activities in India through establishment of CRISIL. CRISIL stands for Credit Rating Information Services of India Limited. CRISIL was promoted jointly in 1987. By the ICICI, that is Credit and Investment Corporation of India, Institute of Credit and Investment Corporation of India, ICICI, and the UTI, Unit Trust of India. After establishing this CRISIL, many other shareholders joined the organization, that is other shareholders include ADB, Life Insurance Corporation of India, Housing Development Corporation of India, HDFC Limited, and General Insurance Corporation of India, and several other foreign and Indian banks. Now they have they are the shareholders of the company. The CRISIL basically undertakes an activity of credit rating. It pioneered the concept of credit rating in the country, and since then has introduced a new concepts in credit rating services and has diversified into related areas of information and diverse and advisory activities. It became public, that it has become public organization, public sector organization in 1993. In 1996, it forms a strategic alliance with S&P Rating Group, securities and processing company. It has alliance with the company. Now it is widely involved in credit rating activities. Actually, what these agencies do, these agencies are the group of experts. These agencies are the group of experts who are involved in the financial market and in financial analysis activities. They get registered as a credit rating agency. And once they get the license of credit rating, they start evaluating the credit instruments which are introduced in the market, like debentures, bonds, or mutual funds, or any other type of instruments which is introduced in the market by any company. The company which is introducing the instrument has to apply to these credit organizations, that is rating organizations. And the rating organizations, by analyzing all the information relating to the company, will give a rating to that particular instrument. The rating is in different ways. We'll study those ratings in the next slides. So now this is CRISIL. CRISIL is the first credit rating agency in India, established in India. It is established in 1987 itself. And in 1993, it has become a public sector organization. In 1996, it has got merged with some other rating, S&P rating group. The second important big organization which is involved in credit rating are ICRA, that is ICRA Limited. I stands for Information and Credit Rating Services, ICRA. I stands for Information, C stand for Credit, R stand for Rating, A stand for Agency of India, ICRA, has been promoted by IFCI, Institute of Financial Corporation of India Limited, and the main promoter and started operations in 1991. It is the second largest or biggest organization in credit rating in India. The first one is CRISIL. The second one is ICRA. Other shareholders, again, the people who have invested money in developing these agency are UTI, Unit Trust of India, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, GIC, General Insurance Corporation, Exim Bank, that is Export Import Bank, then HDFC and ILFS. These are other stakeholders in this ICRA in capital formation is concerned. It provides rating information and advisory services ranging from strategic consulting to risk management and regulatory practices. So what ICRA does is it is not only providing the rating services to the industries, to the instruments, credit debt instruments, which are being introduced by the companies in the market. It also provides information and advisory services in order to improve the good credit rating, how an organization has to develop an instrument, how the companies should develop the debt instruments and equity instruments. These advices are also given by ICRA. ICRA is also providing a strategic consulting to risk management, especially if the risk is high and if it is not properly maintained, and if there is no substantial support resources to sustain the risk, then such instruments becomes the low level instruments and they are risky for the investors. So while evaluating the instrument's quality, these things components are involved into. So risk management is very important key ingredient in developing the quality of any debt instrument. The more the risk, the lower the credit rating is. So risk management related aspects are also provided, services are provided by ICRA to companies. And regulatory practices of maintaining the good risk in the company, all these related additional services apart from rating activities provided by ICRA. The main objective of ICRA are to assist investors, both individual and institutional, in making a well-informed decisions. The basic objective is to assist the investors, both individual and institutional investors, for taking a perfect decision. When they are taking a decision, they should always consider the ratings of that particular instruments. And if the if they are taking a high risk, returns will be high. If they are taking low risk, returns will be low. But the low risk investments will give the definite returns, though it is less. High rating, high risk rated instruments may give returns good, but at the same time, if something goes wrong, there will be a loss also. So this kind of decision-making things can be undertaken. The main objective of ICRA is to assist the individual and the investors for taking the investment decisions. And it is also assisting the issuers in raising funds from the wider investors base. Whenever the wider investments are to be taken, large group of people have to invest in that, it will assist in raising the funds. It will also enable the banks, investment bankers, brokers in placing a debt with the investors to provide. It means that the instruments are put forward for marketing to the investors by this ICRA. It provides a consultancy services and a kind of the mechanism for issuing the debt instruments in the market, to provide regulators with the market-driven systems, to encourage the healthy growth of the capital market, and all that is the basic objective. It also provides the rating services, information services, and advisory services to both the investors and the issuing companies. So ICRA is the second largest credit rating agency in India. The third one is the CARE, CARE C stands for credit, A stands for analysis, and R stands for rating of CARE. Rating agencies, RE stands for research. So Credit Analysis and Research Limited, or CARE, is promoted by Industrial Development Bank of India, that is IDBI, jointly with the financial institutions, that is public private sector banks and private finance companies. It commenced its credit rating operations in October 1993 and offers a wide range of products and services in the field of credit information and equity research. It also provides advisory services in the areas of securitization of transactions and structuring financial instruments. It also provides securitization of transactions in the sense the collateral security, when an asset is kept as a collateral security for any of the debt, till the debt is paid back, the collateral security becomes idle. So this CARE will help to create instruments on such kind of what you call as collateral security, that is called as securitization. Securitization means converting the assets into securities which are kept as a collateral security for some of the loans and advances. This we will discuss in the sixth module in detail, what is securitization and securitization activities when we are discussing sixth module. Just understand, CARE is involved in providing the services in securitization of transactions and structuring financial instruments. In order to structure the financial instruments, the face value and how it should be backed up, how the funds should be raised out of it, all that structural help will be given to the debt issuing, instrument issuing companies, or to the companies which are coming out with the debenture bonds and all that. It offers services like credit rating of the debt instruments, especially the debentures or bonds, debt instruments, and advisory services like securitization, transactions, structuring financial investments, financial infrastructure projects, and municipal finances. So these are all the different various kinds of services that it provides. See, debt instruments are rated with the credit ratings, whereas non-debt instruments like equity shares and preference shares are not what you call as rated, but the advices are given to the investors in which equity share the investment has to be made. So this CARE keeps the track of the equity market very volatility, the scripts of the various companies, how they are volatiling. And these data is shared with the investors as a input services for taking decisions to investors. So that is what we call as, it is an advisory services for issuing companies. It provides information services like to companies, information like providing information to companies, industry and business, all that. And equity research, that is what we say, the data relating to the equity, how the equity price is volatiling, changing from time to time, which kind of factors affecting on the equity share market and all that, pertaining to particular companies, especially blue chip companies and some notable companies, how their scripts are volatiling. All that data is created, and it is published in the form of statistics to the investors. So this is what the CARE does. Very important organization today in helping the investors as well as the companies which are raising the funds by issuing the debt instruments. Now the last one, which is operating recently in our country, just after 2000 and onwards, it is the Fitch Ratings India Limited, FITCH. Basically, it is from foreign abroad, that is American-based company. It is the latest entrant in the credit rating business in the country as a joint venture between the International Credit Rating Agency, DUF, and Phelps and JM Financial and Alliance Group. JM Financial Analysis Group is an Indian company, whereas DUF and Phelps are the foreign companies. Put together, Fitch is established in the country. In addition to the debt instruments, it also rates companies and countries on request. So Fitch is a widely based company which is having a highest renowned things in the international market. So it also evaluates the credit ratings of countries, the governments. So it is called as sovereign rating organization, sovereign rating organization, a multinational company existing in the country. So these are all various types of credit rating agencies working in India. Please pay attention to this, because in short notes, in the examination in short notes, the question may be asked, discuss any three Indian credit rating organization in India, Indian based credit rating organization. Now, then you have to write short notes on CRISIL, ICRA, ICRA and CARE. And or question may be asked, what is credit rating agencies? Discuss the various credit rating organizations available in the country. Then you have to write all the four. Now, credit rating symbols. The credit rating agency, after evaluating the debt instruments, gives a particular symbol to that particular debt instrument. Suppose, for example, a Birla Group is coming with a bond. Say, for example, investment bond called Birla Investment Bond. So now this Birla Investment Bond, when it is introduced in the market, this bond is rated as with a particular notations like A, AA, AAA, B, BB, C, like that. What does this symbol indicate? This symbol indicates the safety in the safety notations. The safety and the risk associated with the credit instruments is denoted with the various symbols like A, AA, B, C, etc. Each symbol has a meaning of safety related things. A stands for high safety and C stands for low safety or high risk. It means that whenever an investor is investing in the bonds, the ratings are taken into consideration. Some investors are taking a high risk, may even invest in the symbols, rated symbols like C related things, where the returns will be high. Sometimes it is risky also. If the company does very worst, the whole investment will go into ruin. Chances are there. But A is the highest standard safety. And A related bonds, the investors will be free from any tensions because the promised returns would be definitely possible. But normally the returns in A rated bonds are low or little less as compared to high risk instruments. Now, if you see the symbols which are normally used on the bonds or debentures issued by the companies by these credit rating organizations, if you see ICRA, ICRA, it uses LAAA. LAAA means highest safety. The same CRISIL uses only AAA. CARE uses CARE AAA. Fitch uses AAA for Indian instruments, AAA India. So here AAA stands for highest safety, means safety is ultimate. Investors need not require to bother about their capital investments. Definitely there will be returns. The face value of that particular bond never gets below the face value at any given time. This is what we call as highest safety debt instruments. AA stands for high safety, little bit lower than the AAA. And A stands for, that is L, A stands for adequate safety. There is a safety, but not as high as AAA. So this is what adequate safety. So these are the various types of symbols which are being used by the various credit rating agencies. Like ICRA uses LAAA, LAA, L. And CRISIL uses it as AAA, AA, single A. And CARE uses it as CARE, AA, CARE, AAA, CARE, single A, like that. And Fitch uses like AAA India, AA India, and A India, like that. It means that Indian companies are evaluated by the Fitch company. That is how it stands for IND in the bracket. And the moderate safety instruments are denoted with the symbol BBB. BBB stands for what you call as moderate safety, not as safe as AAA, but they also fetch a very good returns. That's what you call as moderate safety. If at all anybody wants to take a high risk, little risk, and invest money where the investment value will not go down, but it is not so much speculative in nature, whereas the real returns will be low, but it will be guaranteed returns. That is what the rating stands for. In case of speculative kind of a thing, speculative in the sense, depending on the market conditions, the investors' demands or suppliers' demands, the prices of the security is decided. It is not the actual worth of the security. The intrinsic value is always high than the real returns values which are being gained. So in this case, little risk is involved. Such instruments are denoted with the symbol double B by care, double B by CRISIL, care double B by care, and double B IND by this one. It is inadequate safety. Safety is not so much there, but it is subject to get more speculative. Single B stands for risk prone, little high risk than double B. And C stands for substantial risk. And D stands for default, means these instruments do not fetch the promised returns at all. It is a high risk and these instruments should never be bought, something like that. So this is the credit rating agencies called as, sometimes it may apply plus, minus, something like that to that given A double plus, B double plus, C double plus, like that. They may apply using a C. C plus stands for little bit higher, minus stands for little bit low. These are also possible because at very now and then it uses a various kinds of symbol, but these are the common types of a symbol. Always symbols are the alphabetical presentations. A stands for high, B stands for low, and C stands for little high risk, and D stands for defaulting scripts. So these are the various kinds of credit rating symbols. In the examination question, question may be asked in short notes, credit rating symbols. Then you should write credit rating symbol. Symbol is the safety and risk associated with a credit instrument, denoted with the various alphabetical symbols like A, double A, B, C, etc. Each symbol has the meaning of the safety related things, as A stands for high safety and C stands for low safety. Even D is also there. It is a default, where the investors should always take their personal risk in investing these things. So here I end my lecture on this credit rating agencies. Please study books and prepare for the exams. Thank you. Thank you, friends.